have a comic book called Cape Town, which is supposed to be a mockery of superhero comic books in Tibet. We have another comic coming out called Plug Dome, which is a caveman detective. We have books on Sherlock Holmes, Moriarty. We have different genres just panning across the board. It's just dependent on which writer you end up working up with, or which artist decides to take on the job. In the overall market itself, superhero comic books are a little bit harder to publish simply because the market is completely saturated. If it's a superhero, you automatically think Marvel or DC. It's very little room to kind of get in. People are more interested in comic books that are related to real life, related to what ifs. Like, what if there was a nuclear disaster? What if Superman went crazy and decided to kill everybody in Metropolis only because Lois Lane told everybody the secret identity? Irredeemable. You guys haven't read it? You need to read it. People are very interested in that because they're really, really tired of DC and Marvel rehashing the same stuff over and over and over and trying to shove it down your throats with, 12 tie-ins. But with Capstone, if you really, really want to do a superhero book, like me, I really want to do Flip Relapse, we will find a way to make it happen, and we will publish that book. Answer your question.
No, that was going like for the opposite. I mean, myself, like I'm more interested in that. I love superheroes, and I grew up with them, but I just, I have my own original ideas.
Uh-huh.
And I guess everybody has their own original ideas that don't have to deal with anything with superheroes. Like you said, there's more of like, what ifs.
Oh.
That's what I was referring to. I guess we have some questions.
Can you kind of go over the, kind of like the steps, like you have to get your story idea, you guys get the drawings and your pencils down, kind of the steps on how to get to a finished product?
Of course, there are five main components of the comic book. There's the writing, the penciling, the inking, the coloring, and the lettering. That's mainly having the editing staff. Say, look over your stuff, make sure there's a little spelling errors and stuff. But, first of all, the writer has to come up with an original idea that's really catchy. In the industry, you typically get 3 to 6 issues in order to hook an audience. The first issue is extremely important to get people interested in your book. It's got to be mind-blowing, just ending with, oh, I have to go get this. But if it's not retaining their interest after the first 3 to 6 issues, they're like, Superman. But one of the things we encourage our writers to do is come up with what we call half issues, which is a promotional item, particularly for a free comic book day every May 1st, first Saturday in May. In fact, that's the venue we're going to be releasing the book right here. We have the book ready to distribute. You just have to wait for that date to come along. First, start with the story. Of course, it's got to be original, catchy. Second of all, you send it to the penciler after you've decided to lock it down. There's no more edits. It's final paint. Because one of the things we learned in the first year is an artist would start drawing and the writer would be like, oh, okay, you know what? Instead of doing this, let's go ahead and go this route. Have it ready. No more edits. It's the way you want it. Second step is to pencil it. Pencilers are typically the rock stars of the comic book industry. People go to conventions to see Ethan Bronsteiner. They come to see Rob Liefeld. They come to see Alex Ross. All those guys. So as a penciler, you need to make sure that your pages are compositionally set up correctly. The flow is so that the reader can understand what's happening. Make sure it's action-packed. I hesitate to say in detail because sometimes even cartoon comments are full of a style that people can recognize as your own. Like, if you see Todd Knox art anywhere, you can tell, oh, that's Todd Knox. You see Alex Ross in your artwork anywhere, you're like, Alex, it's great. Make sure it's catchy. You don't want to find somebody that's completely wrong for your book also. Like, if you're writing a manga, you don't want somebody like Rob Liefeld drawing your pages with superhero big buff and all that, and it doesn't look anything like manga. If you're writing something dark and dreary, you know, something very noir, you don't want an artist that's used to drawing happy, big-eyed people. Secondly, inker. It is widely known in the industry that a great inker can make a